Homo sapiens separated from our closest historical evolutionary relatives around 350,000 years ago. It is unclear when exactly the Homo sapien, from now on called human population, reached 1 million, but at the time of the start of the time frame for this video, 10,000 BC, around 2 million people lived on Earth. That's around the same as current-day Botswana, or slightly above the population of Manhattan. Though estimates dating this far back vary greatly. By 8,000 years BC, the world population had reached 5 million, and in another 2,000 years, it doubled to 10. The human population continued to grow with about 50-60% every 1,000 years, passing 188 million in year 1. One millennium later, it had passed 295 million, an increase of 57%. But then things changed. From the year 1000 to the year 2000, the human population on Earth rose with close to a staggering 2000%. Driven by the agricultural and industrial revolutions, the numbers start to increase faster in the 19th century, passing 1 billion soon after the year 1800 and 1.6 billion by the year 1900. Vaccinations and sanitation drastically decrease human mortality, not the least among infants and young children, meaning the population skyrockets even though the fertility rate is starting to decline. 2 billion is passed in the late 1920s, and even though the population is still increasing, even on a global scale, the yearly growth went down during World War II. The years following the war, up until late 1960s, early 70s spiked, with population growth exceeding 2% annually. We passed 3 billion in 1960, 4 billion in 1974, 5 billion in 1987, and 6 billion just before the turn of the new millennium in 1999, finishing the 2000% growth from the year 1000 to the year 2000. From 295 million to 6.1 billion. In 2011, we reached 7 billion, and the estimated world population in 2020 is close to 7.8 billion. Now let's see how that looks on a world map. Half a percent of the world's population lives in Oceania, making it the least populated continent. Australia, one of the least densely populated nations in the world, is still the most inhabited country in the region, with 25 million. Papua New Guinea stands at just under 9 million, and New Zealand at 4. Plurality of island nations in the region do not make it over the 1 million threshold to be visible in this visualization, the largest of them being Fiji, just under 900,000, and the Solomon Islands, just under 700,000. In South America, 430 million, or 5.5% of the world's population, lives in 2020. And even though the region hosts some rather large nations like Venezuela at 28 million, Peru at 32, Argentina at 45 and Colombia at 50 million, Brazil inhabits close to half of the region's population at 212 million, making it the sixth most populous nation in the world. Chile, Ecuador, Bolivia, Paraguay and Uruguay completes the list of nations represented on this map, while Suriname and Guyana stand short of 1 million. In North America, Central America and the Caribbean, 592 million, 7.6% of the world's population live. Cuba, the Dominican Republic and Haiti all have slightly over 10 million inhabitants, while Jamaica and the United States territory of Puerto Rico has just under 3 million each. Trinidad and Tobago, close to the South American coast, has 1.3 million inhabitants. In Central America, Mexico is the largest nation, with 128 million inhabitants, making it the 10th most populated nation in the world. Its southern neighbor Guatemala is the second largest at 17 million. While Costa Rica, El Salvador, Honduras, Nicaragua and Panama all have between 4 and 9 million inhabitants. Canada reaches 37 million inhabitants in 2020, most of them living close to the southern border with the United States, who has over 330 million inhabitants, the largest nation on the American continent and the third largest nation in the world. Europe has 747 million inhabitants. Close to one-tenth of the world's population, even though we here include the Russian population living in the Asian part of the vast nation. In Eastern Europe, Russia dominates with 145 million people, being the ninth most populous nation in the world. In Ukraine, 43 million people live, and in Poland, 37 million. Romania has close to 20 million inhabitants, and Sweden, being the most populated of the Scandinavian nations, just past 10 million. The largest nations in Western and Southern Europe is Germany at 83 million, the United Kingdom at 67, France at 65, Italy at 60, and Spain at 46. Close to twice the number of people who live in Europe live on the world's second most populated continent of Africa, 17% of the world's population, or 1.3 billion people. Africa has a number of well-populated nations, like Kenya at 53 million, Uganda at 45, Tanzania at 59, the Democratic Republic of the Congo at 89 million, South Africa at 59, and Sudan at 43. The top three, though, is Egypt at 102 million, 14th in the world, Ethiopia at 114 million, 12th in the world, and Nigeria at 206 million, 7th in the world. The African continent hosts drastically different nations as small Rwanda, one of the most densely populated nations on Earth, and Namibia, mostly home to the Namib Desert, being one of the least densely populated nations in the world. Finally, we finish off the world with the largest region of Asia, home to, 4.6 billion people, or 60% of the world's population. The Middle East hosts several well-populated nations, including Turkey at 84 million, and Iran at 83. Up in the Caucasus, Azerbaijan has about twice the population of their neighbors Armenia and Georgia combined, and of the Central Asian states, Uzbekistan tops with 33 million, ahead of Kazakhstan at 18. Several of the in recent years war-torn countries in the region host large populations, such as Iraq at 40 million, Yemen at 29, Afghanistan at 38 million, and despite a fast population loss since the start of the civil war, Syria at 17 million. Saudi Arabia has a population of 34 million, making it the largest nation on the Arabian Peninsula. India is surrounded by densely and highly populated nations. Pakistan, with its 220 million inhabitants, is the fifth largest in the world, and Bangladesh stands at number 8, with 164 million, making it one of the most densely populated nations in the world. India is on a path of becoming the most populous nation in the world, and 1.3 billion people live in the country today. Several of the Indian regions would make it into the top 10 of countries if they were independent nations. In Southeast Asia, Myanmar with 54 million, Thailand with 69 million, Vietnam at 97, and the Philippines at 109, all fade in comparison with the largest nation in the region, Indonesia. At 273 million, the island nation is the fourth largest in the world. South Korea has a population of 53 million, roughly twice that of their northern neighbor. Japan stands just outside the top 10 in the world, with 126 million. And we'll finish off with the largest nation in the world. 1.4 billion people live in mainland China, over 18% of the total population of the world. Overall, just under 7.8 billion people live on our planet today. It is projected to grow to around 11 billion by the end of the century, but the high annual growth rates of the 1970s are long gone. With the declining fertility rates worldwide, the coming population growth will mainly occur in the nations with the youngest population, where the population pyramids still are several decades short of establishing balance. All of this we will come back to in future videos.